Hi, Sean.
Hi, Dad.
It's time for your snack. Are you hungry?
I guess, a little.
Let's see what we can find in the kitchen. Here, Sean. Here's your snack.
Thanks, Dad.
Thank you.
So, do you want to talk a little?
Talk about what?
I don't know, about you, your friends, how things were going.
Nothing special.
What do you say we play together for a while?
I'd rather watch TV.
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad, let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
I think we should just get right to it. Then it's done and out of the way. Now, get your bag and get set up in the kitchen. I'll help you.
Finished. Can I go watch TV?
Let me have a look. Pretty good. Looks like you're done. Off you go. Thank you. Do you want me to get your dinner?
Oh, yeah. I'm really hungry.
Okay, I'll go see what I can find. I'll call you when it's ready. You can come now, Sean. Your meal is ready.
I'm coming!
Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
Now, that's not very reasonable, is it? You have school tomorrow. You have to get some sleep.
All right, I'm going. Are you coming with me?
Go brush your teeth and put on your pajamas. I'll come up. Thank you. When the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them. They cried and begged. But it was all to no avail. The children had never been seen again. Good night, Sean.
My teddy! I haven't got my teddy, Dad!
You must have left it somewhere in the house. Do you have any idea where it could be?
No, Dad. Please, I can't sleep without him.
All right, I'll have a look around and see if I can find it, okay?
Thanks, Dad.
Good night, Sean.
Night. Dad?
Yeah?
Why do you look so sad?
I think I just need some time to get back to the way things were.
You know, Dad, what happened to Jason wasn't your fault.
Good night, Sean.
Oh, Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope, can't say it does. Oh, that Lauren Winter. Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Sorry, I only see clients by appointment. It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay? You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ugh, shit, a cop. I should have known. What do you want, a freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
I already told the police all I know and I have nothing to add. Leave me alone. Are you deaf? I have nothing to say to you. Get out of here.
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
My Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
I understand, Lauren. I know what you're going through.
Oh, yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's body on a deserted wasteland. But you're right! Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
What do you want to know?
How did your son disappear?
He used to go play with the neighborhood kids after school. It was pouring down something awful that day. I'll never forget it. All his friends came home around 5. All except him.
Tell me about Johnny. What kind of kid was he?
Johnny was really a good boy. Sometimes he fought with other kids who called me a ginno. In his own way, I think he understood what was going on. You want one?
No thanks, I quit.
That's brave.
Tell me about Johnny's father.
A loser without a job who liked to beat me after a few drinks. He left the day Johnny disappeared. I ain't seen him since. Coward. Good thing he left.
Did you suspect anyone after he disappeared?
I meet a lot of pretty shady characters in my line of work. Sure, I thought of it at first. But it didn't seem to make any sense. I don't believe any of my clients could have done that to my Johnny and all those other kids. Time's up, Mr. Shelby. I hope you got what you wanted. Now get out of here.
Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call.
Sorry, Dal, but I really wanted to see ya. What do you want, asshole?
Lauren, is everything all right?
She's just swell. Now beat it, loser! You again? If you're looking for trouble, you found it. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you.